I think we're everybody's in place. Dean is in the back room, ready to get this recorded, just so everybody knows this is going to be broadcast out to all the fire stations in the city and the ones in the county that have access. So we had to wait until the technology caught up with our plan. So at this point, I'd like everybody to rise for the presentation of the colors from the Spokane Fire Department Honor Guard. Uniform members, present arms. Hoarder, arms. Thank you. Okay, everybody, please be seated. It's my pleasure to introduce Bob Smith, the Spokane Fire Department's chaplain. He'd like to say a few words.
Well, this is always a very special opportunity, and I know the department itself, the chief and others, will welcome you officially and thank you. But, you know, I've been with the department for almost 35 years as a chaplain, and this meritorious award ceremony was, in my opinion, probably the best thing they ever did. It's a time to honor the men and women that make this such a very special city to live in terms of providing our safety and fire service. And we have just an outstanding team of leaders and men and women. It is absolutely amazing. I was, John's coming in. There he is. We're going to honor John tonight. John Knighton is one of our fire personnel here, and a lot of you know the story. Just a hero in every sense, and I've had a chance to spend some time with him and his family, and he's the real deal. I'll tell you, this is a man who loves the job, has given everything he has, and to see how everybody has rallied around him tonight, he's going to get a very special award for his meritorious service here, and how grateful all of us are. You know, on the back page of the program, it says, "In memory of our fallen brothers," and we stand on the shoulders of those who've gone before us in everything in life, but particularly in fire service here. We have an amazing story of those who have prepared the way for what is fire service here in our city today, which is second to none and incomparable. And in these times, we are reminded so very often of the men and women that put themselves at risk, and you'll hear the stories here tonight. So I'm here to ask God's blessing. Would you bow with me as we pray? God, we are indeed grateful and thankful for people who commit themselves and their lives, their families that release them to step out and take an amazing responsibility every day of protecting our citizenry here in Spokane. I'm thankful for all those that give guidance and leadership, Lord, outstanding chief and leadership team, for the men and women that serve on the front lines in various capacities and duties that are out there. Lord, it's astounding, who are every day putting themselves at risk. Thank you. Lord, my heart is always, I wish everybody could get an award on a night like this. They certainly deserve it. But we're here to honor some special people and to recognize them for some outstanding valor. And I pray your blessing now on this evening and all that takes place. Thank you for family and friends that are gathered here. In Jesus' name, amen.
Well, good evening. Thank you for being here. I'm Bobby Williams, the fire chief of the Spokane Fire Department, and it's truly my honor and pleasure to welcome all of you tonight to this ceremony. We started this, 5 years ago or so, in concert with our partners, our labor management partners, Local 29 and SAFO. We began this program to recognize not only the men and women of our department, but also individuals in the community that contribute to helping others in their time of need. So it was much needed for us to get it started. It has been something that we've enjoyed doing and having each year. And we're certainly glad that you've taken some time tonight to be with us. Certainly, we can't put on these kind of events without a lot of work and help from people. So I want to first off start with some acknowledgments and recognition, starting with our exceptional general staff, Lori Bryant from upstairs, who has helped us, Sue Raymond, Karen Ripley, and Bob Cubbage from here at the training center have all been working behind the scenes to make this evening occur, and we very much appreciate that. to the awards committee that looked at all of the nominations that were put forth and considered those nominations. Chief Dave Hayworth, Jerry Shaw, Pat Moore, Chief Schaefer, all a part of that committee to evaluate the nominees. To our chief officers, both from within our department and also our guests, we have chief officers that are here from other departments tonight, and we welcome you and thank you for spending some of your time with us. Our local 29 officers are here. Don Waller is our president, and Don, if you would stand, I'll introduce him to come up in a few minutes. John Goodman, the vice president, is here, and I believe Thad Frater is also going to be with us tonight. You met Bob Smith. He, as he said, has been a part of our organization for a number of years and and really helps us in all kinds of occasions. He has done baptisms, he's done weddings, he's done funerals, so he's a big part of this organization. We're always very, very glad that he can help us out and be here. And then we have certainly our council members, our elected officials that I would like to recognize tonight. I know I saw earlier Council President Stuckard. Ben, thank you for being here. Council Member John Snyder is here. Council Member Fagan, Mike Fagan, I believe, are the ones that are with us tonight. So thank you for being here as a part of this program. Before we move forward with this program, I would like to take just a minute to ask all of you to join in me with remembrance of the members of the fire service who have so tragically died in the line of duty over the last 30 days. Just last Friday, four Houston firefighters died in a hotel fire. And on May 14th, Tacoma lost one of their firefighters in the line of duty. So please keep these fallen and all of those who have made the ultimate sacrifice in your thoughts and prayers. As I said earlier, we could not have started this event without the help of our labor partners, and Local 29 and SAFO, our chief officers group, have been a big part of that. And part of what we do each year is have the president of Local 29 say a few words. And so I'm gonna ask Don to come up, and he will be presenting an award on behalf of the local, one of the awards for tonight. And before I ask Don to come up, I also wanna recognize, I see council member Waldorf came in. So thanks, Amber, for being here tonight. So Don, podium's yours.
Thanks, Chief. I'd also like to welcome everybody here and thank you for being here. I want to take a few minutes to introduce my board. John Griffith, if you'd stand up for a sec. Jason Keene, Shane Skipworth, and Randy Marler. Dave Kovac has to be on duty today. And our Vice President, John Goodman. Like the Chief said, we have an award every year to be given out for meritorious service to Local 29. This year, we selected Mark Vitsky. Unfortunately, due to circumstances beyond his and our control, he couldn't be here tonight. So John Goodman is accepting for him. I wanted to say a few words about Mark. Mark was a longtime member of the local. He held offices of executive board, vice president, and president. Through that time, he had steady leadership and an eye to the future. One of the main reasons that the board selected Mark as this year's recipient was the vision that he's given the local to prepare for the future, to put education as a top priority, and to always develop the next leaders. It's these qualities that Mark has instilled in the current board and all the members that he worked with. So, thank you.
I think a lot of times, because we all dress up for this ceremony, it takes on probably a little bit too serious theme. So feel free as we go through. We're here to celebrate tonight, and we're going to have an opportunity to take pictures later. So as we start getting into awards, we want to have an opportunity for you to come up. For family members, if you want to snap pictures while we're making the presentations, feel free to do so. Just a couple of comments, though, before we start with the awards. You know, even though that tonight's events recognize specific individuals, the success of our department and the outstanding service that are provided by our members is a team effort. We never operate alone. We always do that as a team. And we could not function without all of the teamwork that goes on within our organization. All of the divisions and the personnel of our organization work hard to really to achieve the vision of our department, which is service and protection through excellence. We're proud of all those who make up Spokane Fire Department and responsible for the organization's success. While there have been a lot of accomplishments over the last year, I just wanted to talk about a couple of major successes that we've had. This last year, we completed our first year of providing service to the West Plains. The city annexed about 10 square miles on the West Plains. That was the first large annexation that the city has done in a number of years. And we added the first additional fire station to the West Plains in over a quarter of a century, first fire station that was added in over a quarter of a century of our departmental history. Station 6 personnel who have staffed that station have just done an outstanding job in their first year under the direction of Captain Daniels, who's here tonight. I want to thank Dan and all of his crew members that have worked on building the relationships with our partners out on the West Plains, all of those other agencies. Additionally, this last year, we have gone through and finished the first year with our dispatch center of a new system that has really improved our dispatching services. For those of you that do not know, the Spokane Fire Department Combined Communications Center dispatches for ourselves as well as 14 other agencies throughout Spokane County. And they do that about 57,000 times a year for incidents throughout the county. One of our performance measures is that we're required to dispatch to our clients our calls, 90% of our calls within 60 seconds or less. And for a lot of years, we were not meeting that, quite candidly. We only dispatched about 62% of those incidents in 60 seconds or less. And that was for a lot of different reasons, primarily because of the protocols that we have to go through to make sure that we legally do the things that we need to do. Well, we introduced a new system in August of 2011, and as I said, last year was the first full year of that operation. And in a matter of months, actually a matter of a few weeks, our dispatchers with this new system went from 62% of our calls dispatched in 60 seconds or less to this last year, 96.5% of the calls dispatched in 60 seconds or less. They've done a tremendous job. They certainly are committed to the community each and every day. And I just wanted to make you aware of that, because not only are we meeting the performance measure, and that's certainly important, but more importantly is to get personnel, the responders on the street sooner to those in need. We also, in this last year, along with our partners and the entire EMS system, have put an increased emphasis on community compression only CPR. Compression-only CPR throughout the community, we've been emphasizing that, as well as our cardiac arrest resuscitation efforts. And this last year, our achievement in the save rate was 51.2%, which is one of the highest save rates in the United States of America. And that occurs because of the personnel that staff the apparatus, the dispatchers that we have that start the protocols at the time of the call, and the great EMS system that we have throughout the community with our partners in transport as well as our partners in the emergency room. So in addition to those accomplishments that I just noted, really the members of the fire department make a difference in lives in Spokane every day. Some of the things that they achieve that maybe you do not know is our dispatch center dispatches over 155 incidents on average each and every day. The CARES program that we'll talk about a little bit more reaches a number of families in crisis throughout our community. Last year, about 200. Station personnel respond to an average of over 85 calls per day throughout the community. And all of our support systems, including the personnel in the maintenance division, our information management personnel, training division, administration, all work hard to make sure that these essential services keep functioning and providing service to the community. Probably to say it's a biased view, but with our biased view, we believe that Spokane Fire Department is well regarded and appreciated in the community, And we recognize we couldn't provide these services without the individuals that I recognized earlier, the elected officials. They're the ones that provide us funding, and it's certainly the citizens that provide support at the ballot boxes when we have measures before them. So thanks to all of them for their assistance. And lastly, I would like to express my sincere appreciation to all of the members of SFD for your continued dedication and service. I also want to offer a special thanks to all of the family members of our employees that are here tonight. You are truly a part of our extended family, and we are so pleased that you are with us. So with those few comments behind us, one of the highlights that we always have each year is the chance to share in a video format some of the things that went on that our department was involved with last year. We couldn't do that without our AV tech, Dean Piercy, and the great work he does. So with this, we'll turn down the lights and we'll ask Dean to fire up the video.
Best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock.
Yeah.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
From firefighters mopping the fire up at Chase Bank. Like you mentioned, it broke out a little bit before 3 today. We were told that fire broke out on the 6th floor, contained to one area in a room full of electronics, which has been destroyed now because of this fire. Crews were dealing with office space and say that the smoke damage extended from the 6th floor into the 7th, even as far up as the 8th floor.
For your country, do it for your name, 'cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the Hall of Fame.
And firefighters just wrapped up a complicated rescue after a camper rolled down a steep embankment near the TJ Minock Bridge. One woman was thrown out of the camper. Jane, well, this fire just tore through the south side of this building. I'm going to step out of the way here. Take a look. There's some pretty heavy damage done to 5 units. The roof is completely collapsed in.
At this hour, we've just been showing you live pictures of this massive apartment fire burning right now just south of downtown. Let's give you the exact location to you. This is a 3-alarm fire burning south of Shriners Hospital and Deaconess Medical Center, the location 7th and Lincoln.
Some assembly required. So that was Dean Piercy that actually put that together. So I know he can hear us if we clap. So if you guys would do it again, we'll know it's specifically for him. So let's start working down this agenda. We really want to begin by recognizing the Spokane Fire Department members who retired in 2012. Chief Williams and the local 29 principal officers will be presenting those members with a token of appreciation from the department as well as the local. So I'm going to call each one up individually. And again, like the chief mentioned, family, this is an extremely okay time to come up and take pictures. We're in no hurry and we want to make sure you get the right shot. So I'll start with fire equipment operator, well-known chef, Tony Ewan. Reason I said he's a well-known chef. Station 13's never been the same since he retired. They've been hungry ever since. I'm not sure. I didn't see Rick Starr here. Is Rick Starr here by chance? Going once, twice. Christy Pettit? Three times, four times. I know Lori Lacey is here. So fire dispatcher Lori Lacey retired last year. This was a hard decision for Lori. She's a personal friend. She's a cancer survivor. And yeah. Again, dispatch has never been the same since she left. Congratulations. They always look so happy after they retire. I don't know what it is. Mark Galbraith, Fire Lieutenant Mark Galbraith. I think I saw him. Is he here? Going once, twice, three times. Well, that pretty well wraps up the retirements from last year. I'll start moving through the promotions. And I don't know, Chief, you want to do them all at the same time like we did last year? Yeah. So in lieu of having individuals come up like we did this last time, now we'll have all of the promotions from 2012 come up and assemble in a group for a photo. And I'll start with Captain Scott Hemmelsbach, Lieutenant Aaron Goldman, Fire Equipment Operator Chip Lester, Lieutenant Scott Coldiron, Fire Equipment Operator Frank Sandel, Lieutenant Mark Tejas, I know for sure he's there, Lieutenant Jeff Estes, who called me and said he was sick, couldn't make it, Fire Equipment Operator Kelly Hoyt, should be here, Fire Equipment Operator Sean Galladay, Fire Equipment Operator Scott McCann, Fire Equipment Operator Pat Sanders, Fire Equipment Operator Richie Hansen, Fire Equipment Operator Jeff Braveroff, and Lieutenant Sean Poole. If everybody that's here could come up for a group photo. These are your promotions from last year. Well, actually, Scott, could you come up and say it? I'm just kidding. Thank you very much. Thanks, guys. Congratulations. Yeah, I know. Okay, you're still clapping. We'll clap. All right, good job. It's extremely nice for a person in my position to actually see upward mobility, and the people that have been in positions where we knew that they should be leaders actually have the opportunity to step into those leadership positions. So it's a proud moment for us to see those opportunities come around. And we had a big class last year of promotions, and I think we're probably going to continue to see that as years go by. So this next award is for the CARES team. The CARES team is our community assistance response team. It's a really long couple paragraphs, and it looks like somebody got in here and wrote "Go Eags" on my narrative, which yeah. So let me read through this, and I'll see if I can struggle here. So the program itself was created in concert with Eastern Washington University, Go Eags, to fill the gap between the traditional service, like putting out fires and rescuing people, putting Band-Aids on people, and social needs, such as helping a customer get services like wheelchairs, foods, and contacts to other public agencies. So the following CARES team members contributed over 600 hours of volunteer time per person. And in the very near future, these members of our team will graduate with their degree in social work from EWU, but they will always remain part of the Spokane Fire Department family. They've certainly had an impact on our community, and we greatly appreciate their work and commitment that they've made to our citizens. So come on up to the stage for a photo as I call your name, and we'll do a group photo again. So Marhan Sanders, Megan Martin, Alana Nelson, Alexi Bolin, Miguel's, you can clap now or you can hold it, it's okay. Miguel Zuenga, Adina, Ekrist, Christopher Melander. And I'm sure I butchered a name or two, but congratulations. Oh, really? You know what? You know, that's interesting you say that, because Patty is just dropped a letter on my desk that she's decided to retire, effective here in a couple weeks, so we're going to be missing her. So she's going to get in the picture. We're going to force it. We have that power. You know, interestingly, this program that started in small town Spokane has literally went viral. I was contacted today by the Las Vegas Fire Department in Nevada, and they are implementing a program in less than 2 weeks. It goes live. That is modeled after the Spokane program, after a presentation I did for them earlier in the year. So the work that they do is being shared with a larger community in the United States and Canada, and has been really taken off. So after they collect their stuff, ride on. Did you guys get your picture? Okay. Thank you, guys. The chief mentioned formalities, and we are a very formal organization sometimes, and sometimes there's a time not to be. We have a very formal policy that recognizes steps we have to take for the people that receive these awards. It's a very stringent and it's a very serious job from the committee's aspect when they get a reward or an award. What happened this last year is something we've never had happen before, is we started getting nominations that didn't fit into a box. Specifically, we were overwhelmed with the number of recommendations, specifically from our honor guard, that said, Chief, we need an award to recognize the Spokane Valley Fire Department. Several years ago, we lost the tradition of having an honor guard and pipers, and we relied constantly on the Spokane Valley Fire Department's partnership to provide that service to us. It came to a point where we had enough of the men and women that you saw, which Lori retired out of. She was one of our first honor guard members, that said, hey, we want to do it ourselves. Instead of working in a silo and trying to figure it out ourselves, the Spokane Valley Fire Department members came over and they walked us through it, and they drilled with us, and they helped us develop our team to the point that they could hand it off to us, and we've taken it, and now we work in concert at every opportunity. So the Spokane Fire Department as a collective organization would like to recognize the Spokane Valley Fire Department for your dedication, your commitment to the larger fire service, and specifically Chief Collins and Chief Hale and members of the Honor Guard. We'd like to come up or have you come up here and receive an award from us to you, and sincere thanks for your help through that entire process. So come on up. Okay, it's too quiet. So, we're based on tradition. The fire service is based on tradition. Some not so great, some really great. And the tradition of honor and integrity and celebrating is what the Honor Guard and the pipes and drums are about. And we're very appreciative of you guys and everything that you've done for us. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. lastly, again, one of those things that didn't fit into a box. I got pelted with emails from people across organization, 300 plus people telling me, we want to recognize the collectively known wrench turners, the people that keep our apparatus and our equipment, everything from a chainsaw all the way up to a tillered ladder truck running. And if you know our fleet, you know that takes a heck of a lot of talent and a heck of a lot of time and commitment. We were able to drag several of them out from underneath trucks this evening before they got away. So we made the special award. It's a special recognition for the Spokane Fire Department's Logistics Division, specifically the mechanics who are in the back that I'd like to have come up, as well as their leadership, Division Chief Art Nichols, if you can come up and receive an award. The video that you saw, the personnel risking their life to ventilate a roof, to search a hallway, to search a bedroom, to go through all of the difficult aspects of firefighting and emergency medical systems that our people do, they would not be able to do if it wasn't for the men that are in front of you right now. So another applause for them. Okay, so the formal recognitions and awards that we're going to start with now are from events that have occurred in 2012 and early this year. The selection process, the chief mentioned, involved members in the field submitting a nomination that was formal to the committee. The committee reviewed it, including calling the people on the phone, reviewing narratives from patient care records and incident records, and speaking at some times with actual patients to determine whether the award met the intent of the specific language. So we'll start with the Citizen Community Life-Saving Award. And what I'm going to do is start with an explanation of the award, and then I'll go into the specific details. The criteria for this award, it may be granted to any member of the community who aids in saving the life of another within the city of Spokane. Tonight we have six of those awards. The first recipient is Spokane Police Officer Paul Carpenter. Paul, I'll have you come up here in a second after I get done reading it. On Memorial Day of 2012, Spokane resident John Bjorkman, thank you, was enjoying a bicycle ride when he collided with a Suburban at the intersection in Northwest Spokane. When bystanders got to John, they found him in cardiac arrest. And for those of you that don't understand what that means, he's clinically dead. When bystanders got to him, they identified that he needed CPR. They moved the bicycle in the vehicle and started CPR. An unknown citizen was shortly thereafter replaced by Officer Carpenter, who took over CPR until he was relieved by the fire department personnel from Engine 16 in the neighborhood. Through the efforts of Officer Carpenter and responders, the patient was successfully revived and today leads a normal life. The Spokane Fire Department is appreciative for Officer Carpenter's intervention, which obviously, is he here today? No, which helped the positive result that, again, saved a life in the city of Spokane. So Paul, would you mind coming up and we'll honor you with an award. The background of this is the patient is actually a friend of the fire chief's, and Bobby got a phone call from the hospital when this was all occurring. We didn't really put it together. The initial call for this incident came out as a trauma, person hit by a vehicle. The next recipients are Sonny, Micah, and Randall Hutchison. On October 7th of last year at approximately 10:30, ladder and engine 4 were dispatched to the intersection of 2nd and Adams on the west side of Spokane. While en route, they were advised that they were responding to a wheelchair on fire with an associated victim. Upon arrival, the units found a motorized wheelchair completely involved in fire. There was a female burn patient on the ground, approximately 15 feet from the burning chair, who had sustained significant second and third degree burns to their back and arms. Fire department personnel found that the patient had been removed from the burning wheelchair by Sonny and Randall. There is no question that had they not stopped to help the victim, the patient would have likely expired. So thank you, Sonny and Randall, for your time, your willingness, and your ability to offer assistance to another during such a critical time. So if I could have Sonny and Randall please come up. Oh, wait, you gotta get photos. Some assembly required, it's okay. Okay, Randall isn't here, sorry. This next award is recognizing Jim Gunn. On February 6th of this year, a patient was found unresponsive at the Global Soccer Center on North Division. The victim was not breathing, he was bleeding from the mouth and was turning extremely blue. Jim, who had just been talking with friends about compressionless CPR the night before, determined that the patient was not breathing and began performing compressions. After approximately 50 compressions, the patient attempted to breathe on his own. Jim turned the victim on his side to assist in unclogging the patient's airway. By the time the emergency crews arrived on the scene, the patient was sitting up and regaining consciousness. Jim's actions were instrumental in providing the individual another chance at life. So thanks, Jim, and please come up so we could recognize you. The next award is presented to Waste Management employees Sean Clark and Mitch Atkinson, which I don't believe are here, correct? Yeah. Okay. I'll read it. On April 11th of 2012 in the early afternoon, Sean and Mitch, while in the operation of their normal duties, saw an elderly man leaning against his car at the intersection of Cannon and Central. He was exhibiting severe bleeding from what had been perceived as a wound on his left arm. Without any medical supplies, Mitch and Sean provided direct pressure to the bleeding and, removing a garment belt, they placed a makeshift tourniquet on the patient's arm in an attempt to stop the rapid flow of blood. As one continued to hold pressure and wrap the arm in the towel, the other one notified their dispatch and then eventually called 911. The patient in that time began to lose consciousness from blood loss and began to collapse. Sean and Mitch helped the patient to a seated position and continued to provide life-saving support until emergency crews arrived. It was later discovered that the wound was in fact a dialysis fistula port that had failed and allowed massive bleeding to occur. Were it not for Mitch and Sean's quick, selfless actions and ability to improvise in the face of adversity, the patient would have undoubtedly bled to death in a matter of minutes. Spokane Fire Department, again, is pleased to recognize these two gentlemen for their decisive and positive actions. The next award is our Community Service Award. It recognizes a member of the community again who has made an outstanding contribution to the fire and life safety education through education, public relations, and public service, and runs, and CrossFit, and anything else that I can think of. For the past 2 years, Amy Black has dedicated many hours of her time to put together a 9/11 tribute run called the Stephen Siller Tunnels to Towers 5K. This event helps raise money for nonprofits such as Building for America's Bravest, which actually builds smart homes for military members returning from duty that have devastating injuries. The Hurricane Sandy efforts and local nonprofits such as our own Spokane Fire Department Foundation and our Firefighters Benevolent Association. Through those events, the community and participants get a chance to honor those who gave it all on 9/11 and for the military that continue to fight today. This has been a tremendous opportunity to help Spokane Fire Department's Fire Service Public Education and Relations Division. This event has been extremely successful within our community and would not have happened without the leadership from Amy Black. So for her work in recognizing the fire service and military and helping other nonprofits, it's our sincere honor to present the Community Service Award to Amy Black. So if you would come up, please. I just got the stink eye, so since it's quiet, I'm going to talk about Amy, because I can. Amy's actually a retired firefighter from Wisconsin. Yeah, and you can tell it. She's a firefighter's firefighter, and I wish we had her in this organization, but we have her as part of our family, and she's doing incredible things for the community in that position. So thanks a lot. Okay, moving on to the Meritorious Service Award. This award may be presented to any member of the Spokane Fire Department who performs one or more of the following: an act of intelligence and valuable service, highly credible acts of fire service professionalism over an extended period of time, continuous professionalism as indicated by superiors, or submission of a device or method designed to increase the efficiency in a tactical procedure, administrative procedure, or something that's been subsequently adopted by the fire chief. We're pleased to recognize, and he's not here, Deputy Chief Bob Hanna with the Meritorious Service Award in appreciation for his service to this fire department and the community. Chief Hanna will actually be retiring at the end of this year after 34 years of service. During his career, he's had to deal with the tragic loss of his father, who died in the line of duty on March 2, 1980. Chief Hanna is responsible for overseeing all fire stations and personnel who work at those stations. Bob rose up through the ranks of the fire department, filling all operations positions, as well as spending time on the special assignments such as the Special Investigation Unit and the Training Division. Chief Hanna and his family hold a special place in SFD's history, and it's a pleasure to recognize Bob for his distinguished service through the presentation of this award. Like I mentioned, unfortunately, he's not available to be with us tonight. He sent me a picture on my cell phone from Hawaii with his toes in the sand, so I know he's thinking about all of us. But I would like Don Spencer to come up and receive the award for Bob, if you don't mind. Don is another friend of the fire department's. He spent a lot of time with us in leadership development, human resource development, and his time at the city. And Don is also a cancer survivor. Our second Meritorious Service Award is being presented to Mike Forbes, but unfortunately, Mike's out of town, and in his email that he sent me, he said he was climbing a tree. For those of you that know Mike Forbes, you know that's completely normal, and that's how he would really like it anyway. But he's put in countless hours towards outfitting all of our members with personal escape systems. These systems are a last line of self-rescue if a firefighter was to get trapped in an immediately dangerous life and health situation in a fire. Mike was asked about this idea with about a week left in the grant deadline. He put enough information together to assist in a successful grant proposal. After the grant was awarded, Mike started extensive research, attended training, developed an initial criterion, and with that criterion in place, he contacted and arranged for various manufacturers to come and demonstrate their products. Mike arranged for demo equipment for the evaluation of the committee to test. He personally tested all the ropes, all the hooks, the devices above and beyond the work of the evaluation committee. Plus, he performed abrasion tests, drop tests, and other tests known as Mike tests. Mike video cataloged most of these tests. He combined all of the evaluations, worked with the manufacturers to assure proper testing and certification. He even designed a bag of products which actually held the device and make sure that it deployed correctly. He did much of the work in the final bid spec and the evaluation report. He arranged all of the train-the-trainer training and delivery of the products. And lastly, he designed and led the department training on the new program. He engrossed himself in the project and made it a complete success. So in honor of his commitment to his work, his fellow employees were pleased to present Mike Forbes with the Meritorious Service Award. Station 4. Don, would you mind accepting it for him? Or Ryan's here? Yeah. Ryan, can you come up and accept the award? Yeah, Ryan Redding's the Station 4 captain who was also instrumental in putting all this together, but he works with Mike Forbes. So we'll have him do it. And then we'll send him the picture to his email and give him a hard time. Did I mention that Bob Hanna sent me a text message with a picture in his feet in the water, beach, Hawaii? Okay. So the next award is the Medal of Valor. The Medal of Valor may be awarded to a member of the Spokane Fire Department who, in the line of duty or off duty, distinguishes themselves in the performance of an act of courage involving risk to intimate serious physical injury without knowledge of such risk for the purpose of saving or protecting human life. Receiving this award is Tony Cerquena, Lieutenant Darren Nywert, Firefighter Jason Wells, and Firefighter Kirk Griffith. Let me explain or paint the picture of the incident. In the morning hours of December 4, 2012, while responding to a reported structure fire in northeast Spokane, fire department crews were informed of the potential of six victims trapped in a home that was on fire. On arrival, Tony's engine 15, gathered information revealing two persons were still inside the burning home. Engine 15's lieutenant, again, Cerquena, and firefighter Wells proceeded to search the main floor of the home where they had been told the children's bedrooms were located. With fire burning in the basement below them while searching the home, the crew heard a soft moaning and discovered a three-year-old male lying in the hallway. The child was immediately removed from the home by the crew and passed to awaiting crews for treatment. Simultaneously, Ladder 2 was searching in the basement of the home and located a 28-year-old male victim unconscious on the floor of the burning basement. Together, Lieutenant Nywert and firefighter Kirk Griffith were able to remove the man from the basement and get him to the front yard of the home where he was treated by our paramedics for severe injuries and transported to the hospital. In their performance at this incident, all four of these fire department personnel demonstrated the highest ideals of the fire service and safely removed those victims while operating under extreme hazardous conditions. For their efforts, we're pleased to award the Spokane Fire Department Medal of Valor to Lieutenant Tony Cerquena, Lieutenant Darren Nywert, Firefighter Justin Wells, and Firefighter Kirk Griffith.
Nice job.
I've got nothing to say other than we're extremely proud of these gentlemen and all the crews that operated on that incident. It was just an incredible story, and the rescues were something that everybody trains for every day. They had the opportunity to perform, and we're still taking pictures. I like it. No, I like it. Yeah, come on up there. Yeah, okay. Thank you, guys. Our last award is a Purple Heart Award. It may be awarded to any member of the Spokane Fire Department who, in the line of duty, while involved in emergency operations, sustains a serious injury and requires treatment. Our Purple Heart recipient, John Knighton, is one of the most courageous and inspirational members that we have ever had the privilege to work with. For several years now, John has been battling what has been determined to be a duty-related cancer. He and his family have faced the highs and lows of treatments and all the associated conditions and circumstances that go with this disease. Throughout the entire ordeal, John has maintained an incredible attitude while continuously expressing thanks and appreciation to everyone who has offered support and prayers. His actions have epitomized bravery and has set a shining example for all of us in how we deal with adversity. So John joined the Spokane Fire Department in 1994. He graduated from the Recruit Academy on June 23rd, 1994 with 13 other firefighters. A number of his fellow classmates are with us tonight to honor John and his receipt of this award. He received a gold award for his fitness levels during the academy, which was pretty well indicative of the outstanding physical condition he has maintained throughout his career. John was recognized as the top recruit of his class, and during the presentation, training captain Bob McBride described John as, quote, one of the most coachable, most willing, and probably one of the friendliest people I have ever had the opportunity to work with. His attitude is always at the top. He always did things willingly, with a smile on his face, and is always the first one to help other people. He's going to be a great firefighter. That was a quote from Captain Dave McBride in 1994. So that summary by Bob was absolutely right and is a perfect description of what all of us have seen in John throughout his career. So on February 4th, 2001, John was promoted to fire equipment operator. He spent most of his career working at Station 4, but also working out of Station 2. He served on the water rescue team, the tech rescue team, and has been part of our fire department members that respond on state mobilizations. As Bob McBride indicated, John's a great firefighter who's loved, admired, and respected by all of us. So ladies and gentlemen, please join me in honoring Purple Heart Award recipient John Knighton. Come on up. It's yours.
I just want to get up and say that without all the support here, me and my family wouldn't be where we are today. It's been such a blessing that I'm no hero. I show up for work because I love it. There's no doubt in my mind I wouldn't be breathing today if I hadn't gone into work that shift. You know, and wasn't feeling the top of my game when I left for shift. And if I'd have gone home, I'd have probably nap myself into submission, but I just can't thank everybody. It's not just the department, it's not just the local departments, it's the entire community, and you know, we may be, you know, fighting a little harder battle than we thought we were, but you know, you give it a shot. And And you know, and I really, I'm no hero. You can ask my wife. I feel so lucky that I was able for, you know, near 20 years to show up on a job I loved every day. And there's not a day that goes by that I don't. But I just want to thank everybody and. Can't think of anything smart to say, so I'll leave it at that.
We also, I'm not sure everybody got most of the members of our department know, but Shauna is here with us tonight, and we're glad she was here, and we have a little token of our appreciation for their girls as well, Ashley, Casey, and Kylie. So they're all in our thoughts and prayers. So that concludes our presentation for tonight. We are very, very thankful for you being with us. We usually try to keep these for pretty short and to the point for about an hour, and I think we did that. So we hope that you will join us out in the foyer for punch and for some cake and to get some pictures with the recipients. Thanks for taking time from a beautiful day to recognize these men and women that do so much for this community. So hopefully you come back next year. And we do have, if you've never been here before, even if you have, the Fire Department Museum, a portion that is put together and staffed by Tom Heckler, that's right outside this door. Please take a minute to stop in and look at a little bit of the history of the Spokane Fire Department. Tom, thanks for doing that. Thank you all for coming, and have a great evening.